my patient, Mr. Pratul Singhania, 37-year-old male. He's a banker by occupation, residing in Chennai. Chief complaints, history of fever for 5 days, history of palpitations for 5 days, history of exertional breathlessness for 3 to 4 days. History of presenting...
Only 5 days?
5 days only, sir. History of presenting...
Fever 5 days, palpitations 3 days, is it?
Yes, sir. 3 to 4 days.
Okay, fine.
So, patient was apparently 5 days back when he started having a fever, which was intermittent type, high grade. There was no history of associated cough or wheeze, no history of swelling of joints, pain, no history of rash, no history of any urinary complaints. He also gave history of palpitation on exertion, which was regular, which was relieved on rest from past 5 days. There's no history of palpitations at rest. He also had history of breathlessness on exertion, which he noticed on doing his routine ordinary physical activities like climbing 2 flights of stairs. There was
See, he has got fever 5 days, intermittent, high grade in nature. How you expect that he should climb staircase, climb uphill? Naturally, anybody with fever 5 days or intermittent high grade will have definitely palpitation and will have breathlessness. No? She's still having fever.
No, sir. At the time of examination, he didn't have fever.
Okay, shortness of breath. Fine, the shortness of breath.
Yes, sir. There was no postural variation, no history of any PND or orthopnea. There was no history of chest pain, syncope, no history of swelling of lower limbs. He also gives history of loss of appetite. There's no history of weight loss, no history of recent prolonged hospital admission in the past, recent past, and no history of TIA or neurodeficits. Past history, there's no history of known cardiac illness in the past, no childhood history of any recurrent respiratory tract infection, no history of symptoms suggestive of rheumatic fever, no history of taking any prophylactic injections. He's not a known case of diabetes or hypertension. Family history, nothing contributory. Drug history, nothing contributory. Personal history, appetite is reduced. Bowel and bladder habits are regular. There's no high risk behavior, no smoking, alcohol, no history of any IV drug abuse.
Okay, that's okay. There's no much important history. So, only fever, the total duration is 5 days, and have with febrile. Febrile illness,
yes,
followed by palpitation and breathlessness.
Yes, sir.
It is acute breathlessness or it is what? Acute breathlessness, you are getting
that? Acute only, sir. He's saying from 4-5 days, like 4 days only. After the palpitation, he noticed he's having breathlessness, not before that.
It is functioning class 2, class 3.
Class 2, sir.
Class 2 breathlessness with fever. Would you have fever breathlessness? No. If you are weak, you feel weak. And you have palpitation also. You have fever tachycardia there.
Okay, sir. He's saying, but the first 2 days he didn't have.
Anyway, but whatever, maybe you tell me that why do you think it will be cardiac illness? Some fever and some fever related symptoms. Some breathlessness and what is that? Palpitation. Why do you think it is cardiac illness? Is there any history pointing to cardiac illness? Different history. Tell me.
Actually, a patient in his own language, he said he could hear some sounds, which was very loud. Probably, I'm assuming it's a murmur. I didn't include it in the history because it didn't look very specific history.
That 5 days. So, 5 days, you can give a diagnosis of endocarditis.
Huh.
adaptation. I don't think anything is very special for a cardiological point of view.
But so, apart from fever, he didn't have any other associated complaints which could point to some particular like reason for fever.
I don't think you can come to a diagnosis from history. Fever and it is intermittent and it is high grade in nature, and there is no history such as latent infection, no respiratory infection, or some palpitation, or maybe loss of fever. No, patient become fever with palpitation also, tachycardia. And within 5 days, fever developed and patient developed any complication. So, what do you think from history? Okay, you might have seen the case. So, what is it from history and from your clinical evaluation? What do you think from history? Acute volume of condition given to acute AR, acute MR, flexing in that or ROCV, something like that. Nothing like that. But if the patient develop whatever say acute MR, acute AR, but only function class 2 breathlessness. So that I'm asking. The patient should have developed severe breathlessness, required hospitalization. So it only function class 2 breathlessness, that could be due to weakness because of the fever. Yes. So nothing but from history, difficult to give a cardiological clinical condition from history.
Yes, sir. But
so tell me.
Like he had some underlying some valvular region which was not very significant, but because of the fever.
But you told that there is no previous cardiac illness, no other illness also.
Asymptomatic cardiac illness, which was not known to him.
Yeah, asymptomatic. So from history, you can't say, you know, that's what I'm telling. If you diagnose some heart disease there, you have diagnosed all the disease or some congenital disease, you can think of something happened maybe, and fever has precipitated the cardiac symptoms, aggravated the cardiac symptoms. So from history, you can't think of endocarditis also. Only 5 days fever, no. That's all. So you can't, from history, you can't think of much. What type of typical feature in endocarditis, tell me? In endocarditis, what the type of feature? Fever is a minor criteria. Fever is a minor criteria in endocarditis? No, madam? Hello? Vishan?
Sir, your mic was off.
Sir, fever is a minor criteria, sir. More than 38 degrees Celsius. Yes, sir.
Minor criteria. So, it's not a major criteria for diagnosis of endocarditis. Even yes, without fever, also diagnosis of endocarditis.
Yes, sir. With history alone, we cannot keep it as a positive. Yes, sir.
Yes. Tell me what kind, what do you, they endocarditis but no fever. For sure. Tell me. Empathic endocarditis.
But no fever. Sir, elderly people, those with diabetes or fungal infection, right-sided endocarditis may not have.
Good. That's endocarditis is patient, elderly people, immunocompromised patient. And patient is partial treated, isn't it? So partial treated. Fever is there, and fever is not a very strong history, strong feature for endocarditis. It's a minor criteria.
Yes, sir.
So what are the other minor criteria of endocarditis?
Sir, vascular phenomenon like conjunctival hemorrhage, intracranial hemorrhage, or Jamie lesions, or immunological phenomena like Osler's node, or glomerulonephritis, Roth spot, and
fever, vascular phenomena, and what is other thing?
Sir, this one. This culture positive, which is not fitting into the definite criteria, sir.
Okay. So the culture is not fitting into the definite criteria. Then what else?
Any other predisposing heart condition, sir? Rheumatic heart disease or any congenital heart disease or IV drug abuse or high risk conditions?
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
We are asking just for sake of asking, but here we can't give a cardiological condition from history.
Yes, sir.
What are the major criteria of endocarditis?
Sir, blood culture positivity, that is for a typical organism, positive blood culture, that is from two separate blood culture, for Staph aureus, Streptococcus viridans, and community acquired enterococci. And my persistently positive blood culture, either two sets of culture drawn to LRCP.
Why is blood culture or histopathology? And second is clinical and echocardiographic criteria, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what is clinical criteria?
Sir, clinical criteria is the two major or one major and two minor or three minor.
Tell me what is.
Two.
Yes, I'm hearing, but you are.
Sir, your clinical.
You are becoming silent sometimes.
Sir, minor criteria of fever and.
Minor criteria, I told early. So, some other. No, tell, no. What are the eco criteria? What are the other clinical vascular criteria? Tell those things.
Okay, eco criteria, sir, vegetation. Or intravalvular, paravalvular extension like abscess or paravalvular aneurysm or even new partial dehiscence of prosthetic valve, new valvular regurgitation or worsening of new murmur, it's not considered now. It's not sufficient.
So, fine. So, now, here actually this is not fitting anything to your endocarditis like this. It is not, I can't give a diagnosis from history, I can't give a cardiac diagnosis. Okay, let us go to findings now.
Examination, patient is conscious, cooperative, well oriented to time, pace and person. Height is 170 centimeters, weight 72 kgs, BMI 24 kg per meter square. There is no pallor, rictus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy or edema. Pulse rate is 82 beats per minute, regular, high volume, collapsing pulse is present. All peripheral pulses are felt, no radioradial, no radiofemoral delay. BP 100 by 50 by 0, right arm supine position, left arm 90 by 50 by 0, lower limb 120 systolic. Respiratory rate 18 breaths per minute, abdominal thoracic. JVP 4 centimeters above the sternal angle, with normal waveforms. A was more prominent than B. Carotid bruvi was felt, sir, and Corrigan sign was there, Traub sign was there. No other peripheral signs of eye infective endocarditis was seen.
JP not raised.
Not raised. But sir, he was already admitted for 2 days and he received diuretic injection.
Okay, fine. And your hepatogegaly, sir, abdominal AGR? AGR positive, negative?
Negative, sir.
Negative. What is AGR?
Sir, abdominal compression is given for about 30 seconds and the jugular venous pulse should be sustained for more than 15 seconds. Then it is positive. Hello?
15 seconds, huh? Okay, fine. So, what does it indicate?
Sir,
AGR is positive. And you have to tell patient not to varsal bar. No, Sumit, you have to tell. You have to instruct the patient not to do varsal bar.
Yes, sir. Not to do varsal bar. Indicates impending right heart failure. Yes,
No. That is okay. MBBS, I'm just going to. Tell me, AGR positive, what are the clinical implications of positive AGR?
Seen in conditions like severe pH.
AGR positive, tell me what are the things here. What clinical?
incipient right heart
these are all old terminology that we had in we taught in MBBS this incipient right atrial. What is right atrial? Who says right atrial left atrial nowadays?
Occult constrictive pericarditis or tricuspid syndrome?
No, there is no occult constrictive. You take AJR positive, what is the clinical implication? How many times I discussed this thing? I don't know whether you are there or not. AJR positive, tell me. MRN correlation.
Right.
MRN correlation,
sir.
Right ventricle interstitial disease.
Yes, sir.
The left ventricle interstitial. Left ventricular endoscopy, sir? He has any correlation left ventricular endoscopy?
No, sir, only right.
Has he got a relation with the pulmonary wedge pressure?
Yes, sir. It indicates increased pulmonary wedge pressure, capillary wedge pressure.
How to take capillary wedge pressure? How to record capillary wedge pressure? Tell me. What catheter you use for capillary wedge pressure? Swan-Ganz catheter is not available nowadays. Tell me what catheter you use. Okay, Swan-Ganz catheter you use for that. So, Endol catheter, huh?
Burman end hole
there. Horrible.
End hole catheter, sir.
End hole catheter. Burman is sideways. Burman is reverse Burman. Both are there. So they ask this question. Burman side hole catheter for angiography. End hole catheter for pressure tracing.
Pressure tracing, yes, sir.
Okay, so wedge pressure has got the capillary wedge pressure 70%, no? 77% sensitive specificity of this AJR. So, higher you know, if AJR is, so it is capillary wedge pressure more than 15-18 millimercury.
15.
Definitely is elevated. So, wedge pressure has got decent wedge pressure. Not a right angle dysfunction, not also left angle dysfunction.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so AJR negative, then what else?
The systemic examination, sir, inspection and palpation combined. Trachea central, yes. Sir, apical impulse was not palpable even in left lateral decubitus positions, sir. The shape of the chest was normal, no precordial bulge. Suprasternal pulsations were seen. Diastolic thrill was felt in the left third and fourth parasternal.
Apical was not seen, yeah? Not felt.
Not felt. Very good then. No parasitic, sir. No other palpable sounds. Percussion, left heart border was felt at the left midclavicular line. Right, fifth intercostal space. Right heart border was retrosternal. Liver dullness was in the right fifth intercostal space. Stomach tympani on the left side. So left second intercostal space was resonant on percussion. Right second intercostal space was dull on percussion. Auscultation? Yes, sir, dull.
Okay, right second is dull. Okay. Where is apex on percussion? Where is apex? Fifth intercostal space on midclavicular line.
Not displaced downwards. It was fifth intercostal midclavicular line.
On midclavicular line. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Not displaced. Yes, then?
Auscultation, sir, S1 is soft, S2 normal, A2, B2 normal split, S3 was heard, no click, no opening snap heard, murmur, sir.
No, deeper murmur, let me, what is A2, B2, what is intense A2, B2?
Normal, sir, normal.
Normal A2, B2, okay.
Yes, sir.
Normal A2, B2, so A2, B2 normal, and you got normal split also.
Yes, the split also is normal.
And how much heat and you have got outer and right second doll. Two RICs in the suppression pulses in there.
Yes, sir.
Obviously. You got character thrill also.
Yes, sir.
You got character bully, ma. You on participation told a character bully.
Thrill, sir.
Yes. Yes, Oscar. What do you think from by this time? Because I'm preparing you all now for you know that. Many people ask before Oscars, what is your hemodynamic value now?
So there is no cardio, there's no cardiomegaly, sir, based on the percussion. But with the white pulse, collapsing pulse.
But there's no heart failure.
There's no heart
failure. See, more cardiomegaly, and if it's an acute onset of events,
he should be in failure. I expected him to be in failure, but
and you are only that your BP is still 100, but you are good high volume pulse.
Yes, sir. Diastolic pulse is low.
50. Low.
Yes, sir.
But high volume pulse we got, but BP is 100. So it is a brisk pulse, no? Pulse.
Yes, sir.
But you got a high volume collapse. You mentioned collapsing. I remember it here. Collapsing pulse.
Yes, sir.
High volume
collapsing
pulse. Yes. Okay, so you have suppressional pulsation there, personal lymph node there, right? Yes. Second space is the dog. So what do you think?
Yes, clinically, at this stage, there's no pulmonary artery hypertension. There's no cardiomegaly, though I expected because BP was on the lower side. I thought some systolic dysfunction may be there, but it's not there, sir. Auscultation wise, I've heard LVS3, that may be even because of the severe.
No, we're not going to auscultation. We'll go to auscultation. You told her, S1 is S1 normal, you got A2 normal, normal speed, normal intensity.
Yes, sir.
So you got hypokinetic impulse, hypokinetic apex.
I didn't.
Because you didn't get. You didn't get apical impulse, no? You didn't get apical impulse.
Only by
so it's hypokinetic.
Yes, sir.
And you didn't get apical impulse.
No, sir.
Okay, just finish, then we'll discuss things. LVST, then I have normal blood.
Sure, sir. So, neoarch area, grade 4/6 blowing early diastolic murmur, occupying more than 50% of the diastole, increasing with expiration and hand grip and leaning forward position. And the same murmur, sir, was conducted all through the precordium. Another murmur, grade 2/6 ejection systolic murmur, short, early peaking in left second intercostal space, radiates into carotids. And in the apex, grade 2/6 mid-diastolic murmur, increases with the expiration, heard with the bell of stethoscope, with no presystolic accentuation.
In apex?
Apex, sir.
Long medium or short medium?
Short, sir, short.
It's coming before S3 or after S3?
After S3, sir.
Okay, finish your job. Finish your Oscar final or anything there?
Sir, respiratory system, there was no added sounds. Per abdomen, no sphenomegaly, no heptomegaly. And CNS, no neurological deficits.
Okay, fine. What is your diagnosis?
Sir, I can give a differential. It could be acute on chronic severe aortic regurgitation with mild PVH with no pulmonary artery hypertension in sinus rhythm in NYHA class 2. Currently not in failure to rule out infective endocarditis.
Okay, fine. You just few things I cannot explain you. You told acute and chronic, no? Acute and
yes.
Chronic. But patient has no. Listen, ma'am. See some queries. I'm asking. I'm putting questions to you to answer one by one.
Yes. Sir.
You told what is this etiology of disease? You told acute and chronic. What is etiology? No one out what is it.
Sir, I didn't hear a click, sir. Otherwise, bicuspid aortic
valve. What is your diagnosis? I'm not asking click. What is your diagnosis? Tell me. I'm not asking click right now. What is your diagnosis? You
acute and acute and chronic aortic regurgitation with bicuspid aortic valve with mild pulmonary venous hypertension with no pulmonary artery hypertension in sinus rhythm in NYHA function class 2, currently not in failure to rule out infective endocarditis.
Let's go by one by one. So bicuspid aortic valve. So you basic things bicuspid aortic valve. You got acute and chronic. Acute and chronic here. Is severe or mild here?
Sir, right now severe aortic regurgitation, sir.
Okay. Severe here. And mild PVH. No PH. Then no no heart failure. No, currently no heart failure.
Yes, sir.
Or currently no heart failure, and you are allowed to endocarditis.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is your diagnosis. Then we will discuss now. Discuss one by one. Okay. You got acute and chronic. Acute and chronic. What is acute? Why you are telling acute and chronic? I don't understand this thing.
Sir, because outward
is now they had fever, bad fever, some fever, and all fever precipitated the cardiac symptoms. Why acute and chronic here? What is acute here? Then what is acute here?
Sir,
on what basis?
I thought recent worsening of symptoms, palpitation and breathlessness. Yes, sir, possibly fever worsened it.
Patient has got ear developed and in low breath, only function class 2 breathlessness. All because of fever, no? You might have some fever maybe there.
Yes, sir.
But tell you are telling it is some acute on what? Findings. And that too, you got a right second space doll. How true dilatation and you murmur got left side.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You did mention about the murmur right side of the chest. New aortic area, new aortic area. What is new aortic area? Third post space.
Third intercostal space, yes.
But you got cardiac download and aortic download in right second space. You're not getting, you didn't mention murmur had here or not. See, first you got you left here, you missed here, you should have mentioned that. Because you have mentioned that there is second right second space dull. Indicate aortic root dilated.
Yes.
Ascending outer dilated.
Yes, sir.
Ascending outer dilated, you expect murmur to be had better in the right side. Is it?
Yes.
May not be better. At least you should get some sort of same intensity murmur on the right side. You didn't mention that. Then you go mention that the outer brew, they can breathe there, any character brew there. But there is no brew, no thistle 3 in the right second space. And that I don't know how to explain this.
Okay.
And your brew, you can't explain. Your only your 100 your stroke output is not very great here because your thistle growth is 100 only.
Yes, sir.
So how to explain that a brew in character? So do you think that a patient has autoarteritis here? Or is there bilateral brew there in carotid, but you are getting hardly class 2, grade 2 murmur in the aortic area?
Yes.
That I don't know. I can explain also. I want expansion from you. So let me put all questions then one by one answer. Then you mentioned that patient has got severe aortic incompetence, acute and chronic severe aortic incompetence. Fine. But he is a normal split second heart sound. Acute and chronic, there is no cardiomegaly. That apex is impossible. You are not able to appreciate the apex. Not able to feel the apex in spite of severe air. Is patient requiring emphysema chest there? Or patient has pulmonary effusion, something like that? What? Why not able to palpate the apex? Normally you are getting apex. Even with thick person, you are getting left heart person, able to appreciate apex. But here, being having so much air, you are not able to feel the apex. So how to explain this? Some other tachycardia, isn't there? why are not able to see the feel the effects. Then you told patient has got LV3 and AR patient, and you are telling patient has got no heart failure. Function class 2 heart failure. Patient, I mean, when you say patient is advanced heart failure, you know function class 3, class 4. Not necessarily the JV will go up and seen in the cranium. Patient, we say no, patient has got advanced heart failure. Advanced heart failure means function class 3, class 4. Not JVP is raised at 20 centimeter spinal angle and things. So patient has heart failure there, but currently no heart failure. The currently why the patient has got some function class 2 breathlessness? Because heart failure. And you got LVH3 also. 37-year-old man, LVH3 getting heart failure, LV dysfunction there. So don't mention those things. Then you told mild PVS, no PVS. Something you told, I forget that.
Yes, mild PVS.
And so many things you are not able to explain. Hypercandy apex, having as patient 100 milligram mercury on blood pressure.
So he was very muscular. Could that explain that I couldn't feel the apex?
Muscular? Like, you mentioned BMI, how much you didn't mention it?
24, sir.
Super muscular. Okay. Don't cardiomegaly much. Maybe you might have missed cardiomegaly because percussion-wise, we're not. Percussion-wise, sensitiveness, no. Sensitive space is very less. So, to detect the apical area. So, that may be, you might have not able to detect a true cardiomegaly, clinical true cardiomegaly, because you are not able to appreciate the, not able to feel the apex. So, percussion wise, probably not correctly you are localized the apical impulse. So, that you can explain.
Yes.
You don't have a very muscular, whatever you got. We can think of, and that to acute air, acute chronic, you are getting A to P to normal intensity, that normal speed, who is not acceptable. You are getting a great to murmur, you are not getting carotid degree. That I can explain. Then only thing that you can think of, patient has got some acute pathology, maybe because you won't get a thrill in air, you are getting a thrill that could be Reversion or purposeful cause. You are getting a thrill.
Yes, sir.
EDM, you're getting a thrill. EDM usually won't get a thrill. High pitch murmur, you get a thrill. You are getting a thrill. So that's the reason why you probably patient has got perforation or reversion of the cost. So that's the reason what we can think of some acute event occur. Probably. But we don't know. But only fever 5 days history. So we can explain that, sir, because I'm not could not able to apex. So the percussion wise is may not true apex may not be. So that could be cardiomegaly. And second sound, telling A to P to normal intensity because of sir muscular build. We can explain that. But normal speed, you can't get normal speed. It cannot be normal speed. Normal speed is to me normal speed is normal heart. 90% cases of normal speed you get, 90% heart is normal. Second sound is the most important sound, clinical signs of cardiovascular pathology. Okay, you got NDM in the apex, so do what?
I was thinking Austin Flint murmur, sir.
I know it is your mitochondriosis.
No opening snap, sir. S1 was soft. And AR, the findings are so obvious. I didn't think of MS because it would have reduced the aortic regurgitation findings if there was a stenosis.
What did it do? It drops 100 only, no? No cardiomegaly, what else? No cardiomegaly, no structural drops 100, only what else? Only LVH3. You should tell LVH3 there. LVH3
also.
LVH3 there, so if you had to matter stones, yeah, there could be mild matter stones, what is wrong there? Short MD. You tell that LVH3 there, so because H3, I'm not considering matter stones. That way I can tell there. So that what you didn't tell. I do the answer. So LBST, that LBST, I'm not thinking it is a technical matter. So it could be asking for the marble. Or same marble could be added in the apex. Maybe. Looks like MD in the apex. That is DM. Here, once you go to apex, it looks like MD in the apex. So things are like this. And if you according to chronic patient has only functional class 2 breathlessness, you could have class 4 breathlessness, orthopnea. Okay, tell me the hemodynamics in acute air. Tell me this.
Sir, first heart sound will be...
Doctor, these are the things they'll ask like that because your findings not correlating with the diagnosis. So these are all the negative things you have to address.
Sir, I have a doubt. Sir, if it is acute AR, the murmur is very long, the diastolic murmur. And even, like how can I explain that? I should tell it as chronic AR only at the end of the diagnosis? Because apex, I cannot say it's there's cardiomegaly. Just based on the... And there are no peripheral signs of AR. Murmur was long. Okay. And BP also was on the lower side. It was there was no like higher blood pressure.
100/0, no. You got 100/0 blood pressure, 50/0 coming. 50/0 you not usually actually. It should be less than 50 and 0, 50 coming muffling and 0 absent, you know. 0 still it is sound getting 0, no. 50/0 not possible.
So, sir, I should say it as a chronic aortic regurgitation only?
Chronic only, functional class 2, all fever precipitated these things. Fever has aggravated symptoms only. Fever aggravated symptoms, there is no cardiomegaly. No cardiomegaly, nothing, and 5 days fever only. Can't say, give a diagnosis of endocarditis.
Okay,
So it is,
you can say that there is no functional class 2 breathlessness only, acute AR heart pressure will become very symptomatic, you know that acute MR heart pressure will become very symptomatic, yes, LVEDP will be very high, so pulmonary LA pressure will also raise, and pulmonary hypertension will also be there, we very symptomatic, but we don't get white blood pressure.
Why?
Because the EDP is on high pressure. And there will be tachycardia and the...
Tachycardia, you mean features
of... Passive restriction also may be there because of low cardiac output. So, altogether the pulse may not be wide.
Tachycardia, fast, how it sounds very inaudible maybe because of EDP high.
Yes, sir.
And here, you know, also out component also may be absent also because of the some distress, some depletes. Understand. So tachycardia, so many things there. You won't get white pulse pressure. Patient cold, clammy skin, short EDM, EDM is short, and EDM is it is actually less. So you get low to medium pitch murmur, short EDM.
Yes, sir. No ostentation.
You get ostentation pain. Here, ostentation you won't get, ostentation you MDM ostentation you won't get PC still the ostentation here. Because yes. There is premature closure of the metal valve.
Metal valve, yes, sir.
Because the endoscopy is high. So, premature, you know that this is a condition where we get diastolic MR.
Yes.
This is a condition where usually your LVDP is equal to your waist pressure, usually. Here, your LVDP is greater than your waist pressure. This is one condition.
Yeah.
Active fever here, your waist pressure, LVDP goes beyond waist pressure. So, your, I mean to say, the LVDP is greater than your LA pressure, so that should get diastolic MR. Anyway, you think, only thing that one thing here, you are grade 4 by 6 murmur. Again, I have to tell you that many examiners, they don't accept grade 6 diastolic. So what I say, I suggest you also don't mention this grade 3 murmur, grade 4 murmur. Any systolic diastolic just a grid for murmur, grid time murmur, 5x6 or 4x6 or 4x4 don't mention this.
Okay.
So that avoided ambiguity. So grid 4 murmur, grid 4 dashly murmur.
Yes, sir.
Don't mention 4x6, you are correct. I also accept 4x6, but many examiners they say, I don't know why it is written, I have not come across the 4 grids of dashly murmur. In the Parlava written 6 grids dashly also. So just mention that grid 4 dashly murmur. Grade 3, grade 4, grade 2, 2x6 or 2x4 don't mention. Similarly, systole also can go also. Grade 4 systole murmur, grade 5 systole murmur, like this. So, only thing that we are getting is 3.
3, sir.
So, 3, either person has got first of all eversion or first of all population. So, that's the only thing that I got 3 limiting. Otherwise, and what are the causes of acuity error?
Yes, sir.
Tell us, what are the causes of acuity error?
Acute aortic dissection, sir. Infective endocarditis, trauma to the aortic valve, myxomatous degeneration with rupture.
Myxomatous rupture.
Infective endocarditis, yes sir.
Acute rheumatic fever. Acute rheumatic fever, ma. I'm asking acute, not asking acute severe, acute here.
Yes, sir.
Okay, trauma, endocarditis, after dissection, and yeah, it was in post valvotomy, you do aortic valvotomy balloon, and you can create a tear the valve, I could hear. So, after the name, during catheterizing also, sometimes you can do damage aortic leaflet. But that is uncommon, but only balloon dilation you can create here. We have made many cases. Okay, and procedural. Procedural malfunction can get acute here. These are the conditions to get acute here.
Okay, sir.
So, why there is aortic root dilatation here? Because of the air?
Yes, yeah, so, severe air with the
root. Severe air, to say, there will be more than aorta dilatation. Okay? LV not dilated. Clinically, you are not getting LV dilatation. So, could be aortopathy, could be back aspirin, push dilated, push penetrating, or could be aortopathy with the air. Could it be aortic dissection now?
But he didn't have any history of acute onset chest pain or no such history, was there, sir?
No pain, no aortic dissection. It is deep down.
And
no pain, no dissection. Painless decision occurs very rarely if the patient has a carotid tamponade or patient has involvement in carotids. That in patient has a syncope, pincope and no pain, not perceived pain. So, otherwise no pain, no dissection. And that too, below 40 years. What are the causes of acute dissection below 40 years of age? Acute dissection young age. All your connective tissue disorder.
Marfan syndrome is all the
damage. All whatever they are available in the world. Turner's, female Turner's syndrome, aortic dissection, back is out, all connective tissue disorders. And what else? Cooking, abuse, pregnancy.
Pregnancy, yes sir.
Doctor's not all, okay? So these are the below 40 years you can get aortic dissection. And elderly people below beyond 55, 60 usually hypertensive. And elderly people, they have got proximal dissection or Marfan's, distal dissection, or both dissection possible.
Hypertension, yes, sir.
Hypertension is the most common cause. Otherwise.
Yes, sir.
So you are getting grade 4 by 6 more and more. Would it have, Yes, of what? Rheumatic.
But clinic, I didn't feel.
Yeah, but it is also rheumatic. But only thing that I'm not getting mitral valve disease.
Mitral valve.
Usually.
That's
so that LV, LV consider mitral stenosis, but we are not considering mitral stenosis because of LVSP. So low mitral disease is uncommon to have rheumatic, but possible is still there.
Yes,
sir. But only thing that now, second space, it does not go and get rheumatic air, unless patient has got severely dilated aorta, which very uncommon in rheumatic air.
Rheumatic air.
We are getting right second space dull, so that not in favor of rheumatic. And you are not getting mitral valve involvement clinically because you are not thinking mitral stenosis because patient has got LVSP. And patient has LVS4 in the aortic regurgitation, LVS4.
So severe aortic regurgitation, they can have LVS3 in acute AR. In chronic AR, it may indicate LV dysfunction.
Acute AR?
Severe acute AR itself, because of the volume overload, there will be S3, LVEDP is high.
No, acute AR you won't get S4 because there will be premature closure of the mitral stenosis. You won't get S4, neither will get.
That's how we won't get.
Yes, you won't get S4, remember that. You won't get S4 and you won't get precise to the arsenal implant.
Yes,
acute
sir.
Severe.
Because of premature closure.
So that is the one, that is the cause why the patient has got no narrow pulse pressure. Tachycardia, premature closure in mitral valve. But tachycardia, diastolic blood shock. Premature closure in mitral valve, L left ventricular preload is less. Understand? That is why you get narrow pulse pressure. Stroke output is less because of this. Understood these things?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Fine, so chronic severe AR, you may get S4. Chronic severe AR, you may get S4. And you may get S3-S4 summation gallop in chronic severe AR. But acute severe AR, you will get LV-S3. You may get S3, but S4 is absent. Acute severe AR. Acute severe AR, you may get S4. Chronic severe MR, you won't get S4. Okay, so let's go through these things. So you got a thrill in the aortic area, so that is one important thing here. And you're getting long thrill, long EDM. And so many things, ST, you can't explain, but Calibri, you can't explain. Your second sound, normal speed, you can't normal speed. Pretty long EDM, getting normal speed, won't get. Okay, let's go to the ECG. Have you got with you?
Sir, I don't have the ECG X-ray with me, so this is an old case I presented, sir. But
and any echo there, not echo there.
Sir, he had echo finding. I know it was bicuspid aortic valve with the eventration of the RCC, sir. With the sorry, sir, NCC with the severe aortic regurgitation, sir. With the LV dysfunction.
Most common LCC, okay, fine, no? And then?
Then RCC and NCC, and least common is LCC and NCC fusion, sir.
Again, in listening with your bicuspid aortic, morpholy bicuspid aortic valve and coarctation aorta, autopathy. Is there any morphology, bicuspid aortic morphology?
Yes, sir.
And association?
Yes, sir.
Autopathy, coarctation?
Yes, a fusion of LCC and NCC is most commonly associated with coarctation of aorta.
That is most commonly occur, no? Your LCC is most commonly occurs. What the mechanism is here? Eventration. First of all, eventration.
Eventration, sir.
There is no vegetation, no perforation.
vegetation is there, sir, which was also causing incomplete coaptation, pigmentation. Yes, sir, vegetation also was there, sir.
Ventricular
aspect, sir.
Why ventricular aspect? Blood leaks from outer to LV. Why ventricular aspect?
High pressure.
I thought
sir, in mitral leaflet, it is on the atrial side. In aortic leaflet, it's on the ventricular side, sir.
Why? It's not occurring in India because JD is coming from outer to left ventricle during the diastole. So your trauma should occur in the outer side, you know, why in the ventricular side? They ask you, your MD, you're teaching tomorrow, MD students, they ask them, madam, why happening? Blood color falls from outer to left ventricle. So it is very common vision that outer side will get trauma.
JTP.
But why
you
are telling
vegetation and ventricular side? So because LV ADP is less and aortic diastolic pressure is on the higher side. So it's always on the low pressure side the vegetations are found.
Why low pressure side it is the rule? Why it low pressure side? Why not high pressure side? Because vegetation can't withstand that jet. It washed away to ventricular side.
Because sir, the deposition occurs on the low pressure side.
There is a Radbal effect. It's all old. I book written here. New book not in the correct. In bathroom, you might have seen, no? Bathroom down, the water flows. Water flows down. So see now, you have all the dirty things. You just see it is going towards the low pressure side. The tiles are there, no? Tiles in the bathroom or hospital, in the house also. The tiles are there. And a lot close to that, you know, that drainage site. So all the things, all the sewers,
yes.
they come to low pressure side, downward. So this is hard one thing. Jet, on the opposite side, the low pressure zone occurs. Low pressure zone occurs, there is pressure trauma occurs, and because the blood flows makes eddy there. And you get that become more traumatized, and you get endothelitis and vegetation sits there.
Yes.
What to do for this? No cardiomegaly should be present the antibiotic and follow the case or?
Sir, if it's not a high risk, we can take with antibiotics and other heart failure measures and observe the patient. If there is any clinical deterioration, then he may require intervention, sir.
No, there is no, they improve.
During the course of treatment, if there's further increase in the vegetation size, or if there's worsening of heart failure, or any new abscess or any new vegetation, in that case we may have to intervene.
No, not there. Okay, you nicely gave the antibiotic and your treatment responded well. So they know no fever, nothing, appetite improved. What to do for this case?
So follow up the patient, sir. If there's any progressive AR and if there's any deterioration in any function there.
But progressively, there is severe AI developer. It's severe AI,
but sir, so he may eventually, like he may require Ventol with AR.
What to do? Now patient is responding to your treatment. My question is, patient is responding to your treatment.
Once he recovers from the infection, sir, then he will require AVR with Ventol.
emergency antibiotic give, then cefixime.
Sir, if it is not an emergency, then at least 2 weeks is preferred, sir. Mm. 2 weeks of antibiotic prior to surgery.
Then what to do? Do you want to test negative or what to give? Or just you just give antibiotic and send for surgery? What? No, this how to manage this case now? This case is a simple case now. What breath will get? We will ask. No, you will ask. What are the things will take? What breath will ask? What percentage will ask?
Sure, at least.
You should do many things. You should ask, madam. Tell me what are the percentage will ask for the microbiology department? How much blood will aspirate? Tell me. And when you aspirate, when you patient febrile or patient febrile, you take venous blood or arterial blood. You tell them those things all.
Sir, in his case, two cultures should be negative. He should be stable for 2 weeks. Antibiotics should be given for 2 weeks. Then he must be taken for jaw surgery, sir.
Two cultures,
when
culture? How many hours apart or one culture now or one more time? Two cultures are taken for culture or for diagnosis, to start antibiotic, how to take samples? I mean, also samples for diagnosis or antibiogram. How many hours apart?
The 12 hours apart, sir. If it's a typical organism, suspected.
No. Venous blood, arterial blood, or patient arterial or febrile, what? Patient, keeper comes to you, take a sample or any time?
Sorry, sir, I didn't get
it.
Huh? I didn't get the question, sir.
So when take blood sample, when patient is febrile or it is at no relation to you?
Petrine is better, sir, at the time of bacteremia.
That gone. Febrile, afebrile is gone. So anytime you can take blood samples. Mm. You take 3 samples, what is the first and second sample, third sample interval?
Sir, if you take
3 samples.
Then first and last sample, 1 hour total duration between the first and the last sample.
Is it 12 hours something too? So this question is asked, how much you take, how much you, blood will take, what is the blood and breath? That ratio. How many things would take? Would take only gram positive, gram negative, or only things? Only gram positive will take, or gram negative, or only 1 gram should take. Do you take for any fungal culture or atypical bacteria culture? They ask all questions. They'll ask you.
Okay, sir.
So read these things later.
Okay, sir.
By chance, because endocarditis patient, by chance, they'll ask all questions. Okay, so this is a case of bacterial and probably endocarditis, gluten, vegetation, or vegetation. One looks like sometimes vegetation also. So how to differentiate vegetation from what? Thickening leaflet or some mass?
So it will be oscillating independent to the motion of the leaflet.
Okay. Fine. What are the other masses taken attached to leaflets? Echocardiography depends on the mass attached to leaflets. How do leaflets? One is vegetation.
Thrombus.
Other mass. Depends on diagnosis. Okay, thrombus. Thrombus is good. Which side here? Thrombus will get your mass. Thrombus, how do you leaflet thrombus present? Okay. Thrombus. will visit his native hall, Thrombus. Native hall is Thrombus, why? Tell what is the mass attached to the leaflets. One is vegetation, second what?
I'm not sure, sir. Read this. Read today, endocarditis and cardiac tumors.
So this is actually discussion, not only to know, you have to read also. So whole day you are getting time now, you are from till tomorrow 4 o'clock time you have to read. Every day you have to read something and make a note. So, what are the mass attached to outer leaflets? Okay.
Yes.
Good. Very good.
Sir,
what
doubt, sir?
What doubt? You have a doubt? My God, Vishwan, I should ask my doubt to you.
No, sir. This vegetation will be on the low pressure side, sir. In severe aortic stenosis, it will be on outer side, sir. Then, sir.
No. Always ventricular side.
Always.
Basically, outer stenosis. So same is outer stenosis. There is a pathology there. Always ventricular side, because blood actually this hemodynamic stress occurs during diastole.
Yes, sir.
The valve closes, so diastole.
Diastole, yes, sir.
Whole blood column falls on that outer leaflet.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So opening not a problem. Understand? Opening not a problem.
Yes. What is the effect, sir?
RAD. Read that. Find out literature. Find out what happened. Okay. Anything? Supposing by chance I have told any wrong thing or have discussed the wrong thing, just read and also let me know. Also try to correct me also. But any very.